Hey, LAN Party Gamers. Welcome to CES 2019. We're back here, and we're here at the EVGA booth, where they've got three new graphics cards for the 2060. We've got a new graphics card, the Kingpin Edition, for the 2080 Ti, a new overclocking-centric motherboard. EVGA is big on overclocking, of course, and something brand new from EVGA, their first enthusiast-grade audio card. This is going to be a PCI 1X card that is specifically engineered for audiophiles, gamers, and anywhere in between. So let's take a look at what EVGA has got for us this year. So as always, we're going to start with the small form factor portion of this tour first. We've got the 2060s, and we've got three new 2060s coming out either this week or at the end of January. From biggest to smallest, I guess, we've got the XC Ultra. This is a two-slot full-size card. So if you've got something like a ITX system that can only accept a dual size card, this is actually the most powerful. This is breaking 1800 megahertz out of the box with no overclocking. And of course, if you have good cooling, Turbo Boost will get you even higher. This is obviously ray tracing is involved in these new RTX cards. Coming up right after that and launching at the same time is another XC card. This is the triple wide, and that's how they're able to shorten the card. This is a XC. Now this is just under 1800 megahertz, so this is in the 1700 megahertz range. This is the XC non-ultra, triple wide, but a couple inches shorter. Then following up at the end of the month, we've got the SC, stands for superclocked, and it's the same size as the standard triple wide XC, but it's coming out at the end of the month. It's slightly less clock speed, but it's going to probably be a little lighter on the budget as well. If you're looking for something that can do ray tracing or you can use those tensor cores, then that might be the budget option for you. If you don't need two slots and you have a third slot available, this triple slot card might be what you're looking for here. Well, sticking with video cards, we've got the Kingpin. This is a hybrid card, 2080 Ti. This is going to be an overclocker's card to the max. It's got a digital display on top giving you all kinds of information like speeds and temperatures and voltages and things like that. It's taking three power plugs on the back, as well as they have an extra 6-pin power for the PCIe lanes on this card. Not necessarily necessary for one card, but you can tell that a lot of thought has been going into how can we consistently get people overclocking safer without having to fill too many warranty requests. So on this card, we've got obviously a big fan on the side, as well as 120 millimeter radiator all in one that seems to be blowing quite a bit of air, and it's not very loud, which is nice for people that have room for something like this in their case, but maybe they like to render overnight or something like that. It's not blowing so loud that they're not able to sleep if it's in their room or they're worried about acoustics. This is sitting on a Z390 dark board, and this is all built specifically around overclocking. They've done a few really interesting things with this board. They've added some very high-end capacitors to this system, and if you notice, it only has two DIMM slots, and I was told that the DIMM slot reduction from having 4 to 2 is so that they can simplify a lot of the architecture. They can move components around. If you notice, the 24-pin and the 2 8-pin connectors for the CPU are located at the same right angle at the bottom of the board. This allows you to use different cooling solutions. It allows you to have more achievable overclocks. And of course, with that, you get more stable overclocks and you're able to continue gaming for longer, or you're trying to do your benchmarks. So it's really cool how they're changing the board layout, keeping it ATX, of course, but changing it in certain ways that other companies might not have yet thought of or not have implemented yet. So I heard a lot of Kingpin thought and process is going into this, so he's been working on this specifically. So if you're looking for something to go with an overclock, or you're trying to get the highest scores, or you're trying to beat your friends at a competition on Twitter, this is probably the way you want to go. So this is the Z390 dark board and the 2080 Ti Kingpin Edition. And they're definitely going to be on an overclocker's wish list this year. Apparently these are coming out sometime around February, but no hard date set quite yet. Okay, well, last but certainly not least, we have the newest product from EVGA, something I've never seen them do. This is an actual audio card. It's an internal deck running on a PCI 1X slot. This is something where if you ever have any kind of noise coming from your motherboard or even your existing DAC, they've worked extremely closely with audio engineers to make the highest grade PCI sound card that I've ever seen or heard from before. And I'm not a big audiophile, as you probably know, but the amount of attention to detail they put in picking components to go into this card and not picking up capacitors, transistors, whatnot, off of the local markets or in wherever, they picked specifically engineered parts for this card that are specifically built to reduce noise, reduce impedance, and make sure that the audio coming into the card is getting exactly that out to your ears. There's a direct connection from the large headphone jack to the onboard amplifier, and they're able to do that because of the work that they put into this. There's nothing in the way between the amplifier and your ears. Not only that, is the bandwidth that this card produces or has on board allows you to play DSD files. And these are basically the highest bandwidth file that I've ever heard of. So large that if you try to play it over a competing brand's card, like an Asus DAC or something similar, that's lower end than this, you'll see the bar going across the bottom of the screen, but there will be no sound coming out. So they just will refuse to play. So it runs, obviously, off of the 1X slot, as well as a SATA port. So they got rid of Molex entirely in this generation. So it's about time. On the backside, we've got two RCA in and out, left and right. We've got a large headphone jack. We've got a line in 3.5 mil, a mic in 3.5 fil, and then an SPDIF out, looks like an optical jack. So if you're the kind of person that's in the market for a very high-end audio card, this would be something that you might want to be taking a look out for here. This is the NU Audio or New Audio here at EVGA 2019. Thanks for watching, and for more CES coverage, stay tuned on this channel. This is part of my one-day series. I'm here only today, and I'll be flying back to San Diego at the end of the day. So we're going to see how many different things we can do in a single day. So stick close. Here we go.